computer. Hey, gang, it's John for John today. I run a different ship here. It's a tight ship, people. You just wait.
We're off and running.
No more of this nonsense that John Williams allows in these videos.
I mean, I feel like John feels so, you know, constrained to his radio show. Just not that he doesn't have 4 hours, which is a lot. But, you know, you got to hit commercial breaks and news, and he's very good at being on time, that he likes to just kind of let loose during this thing. Whereas I like to be more regimented, so.
You're a broadcast professional, John.
So. That's true. Right, exactly. It's not like John Williams hasn't been doing this for 30-some years.
An accidental host, John Williams. Now, what is John up to today? Why isn't he not with us? Is this
I don't know.
Dentist.
Yes. Pete was going like this. And I was like, I think that's the dentist, but I didn't want to take a guess. I'm glad someone else said it. He's getting checked. So
speaking of dentists, since we're not on the regular show now, I'm gonna tell a quick story. Last fall, I just felt a little weird thing on my tooth. I went in, and the dentist said, "Yeah, that tooth is cracked. It's gone." And so he sent me to the oral surgeon. The oral surgeon yanked out the tooth, and then it took me months with I had this gap here in my mouth, and I was like really self-conscious about it, and you know, my wife was referring to me as Hillbilly Eric and stuff, and did have a gap. But the long story short is that it cost like $7,000 to get this, you know, new implant of a tooth in my mouth.
Jeez.
And I don't have dental insurance anymore. And I just, you know, it really made me wonder about and appreciate the high cost of some of these. You know, it's a cosmetic. I mean, I could have easily gone without a tooth, but it's like $7,000 for a new tooth. And this includes, you know, the surgeon and, you know, all the other crap. But you know, what do people do? Don't have $7,000 they can call on immediately.
They don't, Eric. They just
I know.
Don't.
And it's a shame. And anyway.
My brother is married to a Polish woman, and they go to her family dentist in Poland. It's cheaper, and then they can afford the flight, and it's still cheaper than having their dental work done in the U.S.
Wow.
Yeah. I was going to say, a friend of mine who grew up with bad dental care went to a dentist school.
Mm-hmm.
I forget which school here used to have a dental school, and I think it's gone.
Hillcrest Elementary.
He went there, and that was really how he caught up. Otherwise, he could never have done it.
Especially if it's one of the teeth in the back. I mean, kid messes that up, you're okay, right? I mean, at least you got a tooth there now. Any of these, I'm not going to a student, though. But yeah. It's a sad state of affairs. This is my PSA for everyone to start an HSA as soon as they can in life. For those unexpected little things that happen. It's the triple tax savings benefit. It's almost like I host a financial show. Health savings accounts, listeners and viewers, get them.
And floss.
And floss.
So I've derailed the conversation. What are we going to talk about today?
I'm going to do the mayor 1 year. I am going to dive us into... Oh, there's going to be a little rapid fire off the top, so be ready for the questions. We'll do in the day of action thing. Eric, I know you're fired up about that. I heard you with John yesterday. I want to talk about the new Florida Man Museum and then, or the Griffin Museum of Science and Industry.
Oh. Florida Man.
And then that took a second. And that's okay. No, it was a little veiled.
No, I like that.
And then the quickest agreement on debates that's ever happened, coming soon to a television station near you. Does that sound good, guys?
That sounds wonderful.
All right. Yep. I'm going to stop this recording now. Right? Correct? All right. Good.